Everything you need to know before joining Concordia University, we'll discuss in this video. Hey everyone, I'm your average guide Sahil Gogna. Welcome back to another video. For those who don't know me, I'm a data integration developer in a Montreal-based company. And till now, I have been preparing a lot of content revolving around pursuing masters in Canada and also about the Canadian industry after masters. I've also uploaded various videos revolving around a lot of courses offered at Concordia University, and I have been getting a lot of questions related to those videos. So I thought, why not make a separate video and address all the questions related to Concordia University. So in this video, we are going to answer those questions. So without any delay, let's get started. So the first question that I get is around how to choose a course and how to choose a course that can get you a good grade. So firstly, you need to get the list of all the available courses for that term. You can simply do it by logging into your My Concordia portal and get the list. And also you can filter the courses based on the term and according to the department. In Concordia University, there's a concept of courses for the department and out of department. So just filter out the courses that you are interested in. So once you have the list, now comes the important part, shortlisting the course. So one thing you can simply do is by going through the list and select the course whichever interests you. I know, this thing is very difficult because you might be wondering how to select a course which is easy or how to know which course can be difficult, right? So one thing you can simply do is by reaching out to students who have already taken that course in the previous term or simply reaching out to your alumni network through LinkedIn and get the review. But one thing you need to make sure is that when you are taking a course based on someone's review, always ask them like which professor taught them. Because a subject can be taught by different professors based on the term that you take, and every professor have their own way of teaching and has their own curriculum. So like one professor can give you a lot of assignments and easy exam, but the other professor can give you less assignments, maybe the exam and stuff. So it depends upon professor to professor. So this thing you need to make sure while asking the students. The other thing that you can do is reach out to your program coordinator. Once you reach them, they can always suggest to you the courses that students generally take according to the term that you are taking in, and also according to your background and according to your interest, which course can be good for you. But the best thing is that to reach the student network. So the next question that I generally get is around changing the program. So let's say a student is joining the Concordia University as a part of software engineering program and they want to switch it. So students ask me, can they do this? So the straightaway answer is yes. But I talk to a lot of Concordia University students to inquire about this, and it's not that easy. It's not something that you wish and it happens in an instant. So there are certain things that you need to keep in mind if you are planning to change your program. So the first thing is that there's a concept of department and out of department courses. So it's a general rule in Concordia University that you are allowed to take only two courses from out of your department. Let's say that you are not sure if you want to continue your degree in the same program that you have taken or that you have been accepted to, and then it's always advisable to take the courses from that department or that program in which you are interested into switching. In that case, you have to achieve very good grades. And then when you reach the program coordinator, they will generally ask you about your grades in the programs that you have taken from the department that you're interested in. So in that case, these things can turn into your favor. But then also it doesn't ensure that your program will be switched. So one thing is that, let's say you are from electrical background and you are here in, let's say, computers and electronics, right? And you want to switch your degree to software engineering or applied computer sciences. In that scenario, you might need to take the courses which are prerequisite since your background is totally different from the program that you're interested in. So it's always advisable to discuss it with the program coordinator. So now let's move to the third question. So I'm generally asked by the students that how to network with the students who are already in the university. So the first thing that I can suggest you is to attend the TA sessions. I know no one likes to attend the TA sessions, but these can be really beneficial. So the first thing is that the TA, he or she can be a graduate student just like you, but more experienced. So it's always wise to discuss your queries with them or learn from their experiences. The second thing is that you get a chance to network with your classmates. So your classmates can be also from different experience level, because it might be your first semester and their last semester. So you can always learn from their experiences. And the next point that I can think of is there are student bodies like GSA or ECSGA, in which are selected by the students, and you can always reach to your program coordinator to ask the details of the students who are representing those bodies, or you can also get their details from the university website. You can reach them for any doubts, be it related to the course, be it related to the networking or life in Canada. So it's always wise decision to reach the people around you. So now let's move to the next question. I'm generally asked about the on-campus job opportunities. So the best perk of working on campus is that you can work as many hours as you want. So if you want to get details of the on-campus job, you can easily go to Concordia University website and get the list of all the on-campus jobs which are available. Now you must be curious to know, like, what are the types of jobs that you can apply if you are applying for the on-campus, right? The first one is quite obvious. It's for the TA position. If you want to get a TA position, so you need to take that course and get a very good grade. I know this thing was very obvious, but I just wanted to highlight the point that if you want to be a TA, you have to work really hard and get very good grade in that course. So the next type of job that you can always apply is for the network support. So the people who are in the network support team, they generally assess the new students related to the issues related to their profile, or they might get some network issues on their machines. So it's a very chill type of job. And the other job that I can think of is the exam invigilation. So now, I don't think that it's the on-campus job, but because anyone from even outside Concordia can apply for these type of job, and this is a very good job to get some side income. So the next question that I generally get is about the on-campus placements. Now this question has to be tagged the most asked questions by the student. So we will discuss this thing not only specific to Concordia University, but in general in Canada. So in India, we have a concept of companies visiting campus and in a particular term and then conducting a series of, let's say, tests and interviews to hire the students, right? But here the things are somewhat different. Here we have the concept of career fairs where the companies visit a university just to network with the students, and they are not intended to hire the students. So in that case, the companies, they generally set up their stalls or booth, whatever we call them, and the company is represented by the HR or maybe the tech team if it's a technical company. And you can always get to know about the product and services they offer. You can also ask them about the requirement of the team, and in case your skill set is a direct match for whatever they're looking for, you can get their email addresses or LinkedIn handles and drop off your resumes. And it's a high possibility that you will get an interview call since they are directly getting what they are looking for, right? And even if your resume or let's say your skill set is not a complete match for the person they are looking for or the profile they are offering, it's always advisable to get in touch with them and network with them. So that even if they, in the future they post some of the requirements or the job posting, you are the first one to get the notification, and you know, you can always apply for those types of jobs. Now these career fairs, they can be exclusively for the university students or open to anyone depending upon the university that's hosting them. But the point that I wanted to make here is, like, you can imagine it as the off-campus placements that we do in India, right? So there's nothing like the concept of on-campus placement. It's generally the career fairs where you go, you network with different people, and then you get a job. So guys, we have reached at the end of the video. I hope I have answered all your questions. And in case I have missed any question, make sure to drop them in the comment section below. And in case you are struggling with some other queries or other questions, don't worry, I'm here to help you. And you can always reach me via Instagram or drop me an email. Make sure to subscribe the channel. See you in the next video. Till then, stay safe.